Well, hello. Welcome to another edition of Turk's Tips and Tricks. Today, we're going to take a look at some of the new features within NX2212. For an agenda, very briefly, we're going to talk about Geometric Solutions, the company I work for, who we are, most importantly, how can we help. Then we're going to jump into our subject. We're going to look at some, and I say some because there's a lot more than what we can show in this webinar, but some of the updates in 2212. So it's going to be some core modeling, advanced shape design, some advanced modeling techniques, a new package that we have, NX2D Edit, and then a little bit about some CAD and CAE integration, and a couple of measuring enhancements. So we've got a lot to get through. My name, Dan Turk, Application Engineer with Geometric Solutions. Now, Geometric Solutions, the company I work for, we have a saying around here, and that's that we walk the talk. Essentially, the things that we're selling, these pieces of Siemens software, it's not just that we sell them, no, we use them. And we'd like to think that we use them rather successfully. So do you have any needs? Consulting, engineering services, training, support? Well, then just let us know. The owner of our company, he said it best. He said, our ability to successfully partner with our customers comes from our experience in using the tools we sell every day. So we're using these tools, and for me, I am using and loving NX2212. The first thing we're going to do is look at NX. And we want to look at our Discovery Center. So typically when you first fire up NX, you'll see Discovery Center. If it's not there, then go to Menu, View, and almost to the bottom, Discovery Center. Now what's nice about this is I can click on what's new and what's new since, how about the last release, 2206? And you'll notice that in that one release, look at all of the new things. And the nice thing about this is you can click on any one of these and take a look at an article that talks about how that tool works and how to use it. So there are a lot of new items from NX2206 to NX2212. So after watching this webinar, go on to the Discovery Center and just take a look and see what's new for you. Some of the key improvements of this release of NX2212, one of the big ones, sketching. So it's an improvement in how we do patterning, and also if you have a sliding or remote relation, how it's going to be able to find that. Another one is there's been a lot of requests for threads to be improved. We're going to show you how you can put a thread through multiple pieces all with one shot. And then also, we had some nice enhancements with draw shape, class A surfacing, some of the algorithmic modeling tools. Even if you're not using these, it's worth watching so you can see what's new, and that might trigger, hey, we could use that, or perhaps we could get a demo of it. We're also going to look at a nice tool called NX Design Space Explorer, and a new product, NX2D Edit. Now, this is a really interesting one because it allows us to use the 2D side of NX instead of using AutoCAD or any of the other DXF, DWG programs. That way our workflow, it can stay the same. All right, so first up, we're going to look at some of the core modeling enhancements. The first one we're going to talk about is sketching. So there's a new pattern functionality within the sketch. It's going to increase your productivity. And it allows you to have your sketch, or your pattern rather, find relations or not find relations. The key is at the very bottom of my little spreadsheet here. Older sketches, they can be renewed to use the new functionality. So if you've got some old models out there that are still good, you can use them and update them. Let's jump in and take a look at how this works. We're going to go into our sketch, And here you can see the part that we have. So it's a pattern of five, and then there's five boxes above that were not created with the pattern. So you can see that when I hold over that linear, that pattern, that's showing me exactly what was going on or how these parts were made. Now the interesting thing is if I go and make some changes, you can see what's happening. So these four boxes, they're not lined up. Now this one is, but the other ones are not. And if I wanted to get rid of that, of course, I could just relax the relation. Let me do a couple of undos. And we're going to go inside of our pattern. And here's where we have something new. And that's this relation finding scope. So right now it's looking at the input curves. So that's where we moved one and just these guys moved. What about no finding to pattern? Let's turn that on and see what happens. So there's no relation now with this pattern whatsoever. Do a couple undos. Let's go back into the pattern again. This time we're going to change it to selected instances. Now this is pretty cool. I want instance one, instance two. These are the only ones that I want to find any relations. So look at that. Just those two and the two above it, they update. Pretty cool. Oops, a couple more undos. There we go. Let's go look at the last one. Olive pattern. All right, it's pretty obvious what this is going to do, right? Everything adjusts. So it's a nice enhancement that we have within the patterning that we can choose to automatically have these ones grab or not so that you can have pieces close to each other and not have the relations if you don't want them to. Nice little enhancement. Another enhancement that we have is that the sketch relations, they won't fall off anymore. And what do we mean by that? Well, if you just take a look at our part, we've got this little circle and it's tangent. Well, if you were to take that and move it off of the line, what would happen in previous versions is once you slide it off, the relation goes away. Well, that no longer happens. So now we get to keep that relation. Let me just show you very briefly how this works. All right, so I've got a line drawn and a circle, and I'm just going to bring that up and touch, and you can see it's going to add a tangent constraint, just like we would expect. But then when I move it off, now you can see an extension line, and I get to keep that tangent constraint. That's a simple one to be sure, but pretty good. There's some other good enhancements with sketching in NX2212. The thing I want to point your attention to on the first line, continuous release. So what we're stating here is this is something that's ongoing. So we had that new sketch solver a couple of years back. Well, they're continually working to improve it. The second point, user requested enhancements. Yes, these enhancements, these are from you and from me. The things that the users that we liked or didn't like. And you can see those five bullet points. Essentially, the sketch solver, it was overly sticky in some instances. And so there's been a bunch of improvements, enhancements for that. And you can look at these on your own when you jump into NX. Another enhancement that we had was if you have multiple bodies and you want to subtract out threads, that it could subtract through multiple bodies. This is again a feature that was requested through the community. Let's take a look at how it works. We're going to go ahead and add some thread to our cylinder. So we've got the cylinder with the thread, and now we're just going to simply subtract it out. So we've got two pieces we want it subtracted from. We're going to choose that thread, and it subtracts it. If we look at the bottom side, there you can see the thread, and it's kind of hard to see on the top, so we'll just make it wireframe. And there you can see threads on both parts. Now, as it said in the notes, this was more of an industry-specific thing. So if this is your industry, you're probably smiling right now. The next enhancement we're going to look at, again, this is from the customers, from the field, it was that when you wanted to go and move an object, you wanted to move the object, you got so much information. We got all of the planes that came into place. It was just a lot there. This is a simple enhancement, but a pretty profound one. New is it's just going to show us the CSIS. So it simplifies things. It makes it easier when you're moving something. Another new feature that we have, it's for drafting only, but it allows us to move objects in a delta. So basically moving it in X in the Y, and we can do that really easily and quickly. Another nice enhancement that we have has to do with wave, or the wave geometry linker. Now you're able to take the material and inherit it from the part to the wave-linked body. Now, just a note, you'll have to go in your settings and you have to turn that on to inherit the material. Conversely, you can remove the material if you want. You go into the settings and you just turn off the inherit material button. Next up, we're going to look at some enhancements with advanced shape design. So we're going to look at draw shape, bridge curves, X-form, the highlight line, deviation, surface continuity. That's where we can see what's going on with our surface. And then we're going to look at some other studio surface and N-sided surface enhancements. The first enhancement we're going to look at is with the draw shape tool. Now, the draw shape, in case you didn't know, it gives you an environment that allows you to do like freehand drawing within NX. So it is phenomenal for conceptual or even down to the detailed engineering phases of a design. But some of the nice enhancements are taking existing geometry, existing curves, and being able to use them and put them right onto our surface. Let me show you how it works. So here you can see we've got a shoe and we've got the letter NX. We're simply going to select the faces that we want to draw on. And then we're going to use this draw shape, project curve. We'll simply choose our vector and it's going to project it right onto that surface that we're able to draw on. We'll do an offset. And let's put in some fillets. Just one more. Good. From here, we want to just offset the face. And we're going to choose a boundary as the new pieces that we just put in. And then we can see this dynamically, what it would look like. And there we have it. So we were able to take that N, project it on, and make it usable. The next enhancement we're going to talk about is the simplification of bridge curves. In previous versions of NX, when you would create that bridge curve, you'd get a lot of different poles. On NX2212, it's going to minimize that. So if you look at the little drawings to the top right, so G0, that's to a point, so we don't have a pole there. G1, tangent, now you're gonna have one pole. G2, curvature, you're gonna have an additional, and the list goes on and on. Also, another enhancement was the ability to go to the midpoint, to snap to a midpoint of a spline for our bridge curves. Next, we're going to look at some enhancements that are going to help to speed up the process of creating complex shapes. So the first one is with the studio surface. What this is going to do is it's going to help us to identify gaps quickly as we're setting up our surfaces. Second, X-Form. The nice thing here is with X-Form, you can quickly launch it by right-clicking on a face sheet, and then there's that X-Form option. You also have the ability to work in a symmetry mode. Inside its surface, it's a pretty simple enhancement. You can now go to G2. So prior to this, it was just G1, continuity or tangent, but now we can have curvature. And the last one is snip surface. The enhancement here is you can project your snipping surface or that curve that you're using. You can project it both sides. So you can just imagine the benefits that come along with that. And what it does is it makes it more consistent because other commands have been able to do that. If you're doing surfacing, likely you're also doing some analysis, quality analysis. You want to make sure everything is working right. The enhancements here is just performance enhancements. So the dynamic deviation gauge, the highlight lines, in typical cases, it's just a lot faster, twice the speed. Also, surface continuity. Now, if you move your mouse over any of the edge pairs, it's going to show what that surface continuity is. And then if you notice on my screen on the bottom right, we have obstructed and on top. This is more for a presentation, but you can now choose, do you want those labels? Do you want them to be obstructed where you have to, as you move the model, you'll be able to see the numbers? Or do you always want to force them to the top? So what's your choice? Either way, you can make that adjustment in the customer defaults. Next up, we're going to look at some advanced modeling techniques. This would be algorithmic modeling and the Design Space Explorer. For algorithmic modeling, the main point that I want you to take from this very busy slide is that there are new nodes. So new nodes that can get you information, orientation, they can get some parameters, all sorts of different bits that you can use when creating your algorithmic models. Also, we've reduced the selection step for easier user interaction. And what this has to do with is we're able to reverse the parent-child relationship, and we're able to do so quickly. There's also improved options and outputs of existing algorithmic nodes. So we have enhanced divide curve node, enhanced collect faces node, enhanced measure node, and then improved random points node. So each one of these, they've been improved or enhanced. There's also enhancements when it comes to the text. So if we want to have text on a specific portion of our part, and we want the algorithm to drive that, well, there's been some enhancements with this as well. Next, we're going to look at the NX Design Space Explorer. There's been a number of different productivity enhancements. And so what this tool allows you to do is to simulate or to explore hundreds or maybe thousands of variations of your design. And then you can put all of those on a Pareto chart and you can take the weight, so to speak, and find what's the best type of design. So there's been lots of enhancements with this. For this one and for algorithmic modeling, we really only spent a few moments on it. Would you like to learn more? Well, then you will find my contact information at the end. Next up, we're going to look at the NX2D Edit. Remember, this is a brand new application that we have. So it's actually a lightweight, standalone application for editing 2D drawings. Now, you could be thinking, at your company, you're using other programs to deal with your DWGs, your DXFs, and then you're having to do lots of translation back and forth to your designers. Well, we don't have to do that anymore with this new tool that we have. And the nice thing is that it's using that new sketch solver. So even on a, so to speak, dumb DWG, DXF type file, it's going to have a lot of intelligence built into it. Let me show you what I mean. So here we have our NX2D edit, and we have all of the sketching tools. We can add notes, cross hatches, fills, and so on. We're going to import a file, and it could be any type of DXF or DWG. I've already got some of these settings pre-configured, but we can see a preview. We'll bring that in, and we're going to bring it in and start sketching right away. So you'll notice there's our finished sketch. So we are inside of the sketch to begin with. And we have all of the sketch tools. Let's go ahead, and just to make it easier to see, we're going to change the color of everything to make it more monochrome. So we'll just change it to black. There we go. Now that's looking good. You'll notice as we click and drag a line, the dimension, it updates. But also towards the bottom, we can see the difference too. That's that sketch solver that's in place. The dimensions, they could be driven, or we could have them set to driving. This time we'll just click and drag, and it's nice. You can see where those found relations are. So it's taking both pieces and, so to speak, it's keeping them together. We'll change this 152 to make it a driving dimension. And here again, same kind of thing. We'll go ahead and select some extra geometry, and very quickly, look how we're able to make a quick edit. When it comes to the title block, of course, this is just the Siemens one, but we could go in and make any types of changes that we want. We could add our notes, so we could give it the title, the drawing number, anything that you want on there, you could go ahead and put it. We can even add some cross hatching. So we'll just select in a couple of areas. There's some cross hatching. Maybe we want to add a little bit more, some area fill. That looks good. The key point here, though, is that this is actually an NX part file. So once I hit save, that's what it's going to be. You can then take this, open it up by one of your designers, and it'll stay right within NX. You don't have to leave the NX workflow to work on a DWG or DXF type file. With this new tool, you can have it at a much better price, a standalone 2D option. Next, we're going to look at some CAD and CAE integration. Specifically, we're going to look at the mid-surface because there's been a number of enhancements with mid-surfaces. So just some of them is automatic edge-to-edge stitch during the FEM creation. We also can preserve imprints. So if you think about a washer, what that would look like on the part. Well, it's going to maintain that imprint. Some other enhancements that we have, the ability to reverse sides 1 and 2 during a manual pairing. We can now mirror and pattern geometry of mid-surface features, and that's going to transfer the thickness. And then some manual pairing usability improvements. So as the mid-surface goes, just improvements the whole way around. The last two enhancements that I'm going to show have to do with measuring. So the first is just that there is an update to the minimum perpendicular distance. And what that is that theoretical extension line. You can see it on our screen, but that's new. That way we can get the minimum, the maximum perpendicularity, what that distance is going to be, and it'll even do it along that theoretical extension. Another nice enhancement that we have is an associative principal moment of inertia. Essentially, we're able to take a cross section like what we have here, and then we can calculate that moment of inertia, get the center, a whole bunch of other information that we couldn't get before. So check those both out. So to this point, what have we seen? Well, we've seen lots of benefits that come with NX. Likely you've noticed that a number of times the things we've talked about were the things that the users, that the community requested. So the technology that we have with Design Space Explorer, it's the best in class capabilities for really optimizing your design. You got to see that with the sketch enhancements, we can have more robust, faster, quicker, better modifications. And shape design, it's never been so easy when using NX. Those are just a few of the many enhancements in NX2212. I'd like to take this time to thank everyone for your time and for your attention. If you have any questions, please feel free to send us an email at solutions@goplm.net. You can also scan that QR code to learn more about our upcoming events. Thanks, everybody. Have a great day and be safe.